I just want you to, in your spiritual imagination, think of the possibility of a place in Spokane where you could go anytime, night or day. Furthermore, that place holds something, the presence of God, in a manifest, visible way. The kind of place where you come in the door and there is God. And at any time, day or night, someone can come. A landing place for the presence of God. Imagine a place. It's going to vibrate with the atmosphere of heaven. There'll be bands. There'll be intercessory worship. As that worship goes up to the Lord, hearts are melting. And they're finding, coming into attunement with the God of the universe. Imagine a place where intercessory prayer goes up. Night and day, but more than night and day. Moment by moment by moment, unceasing. Imagine a place that is not about anybody's church or anybody's outreach or even a grand finale effort of a Billy Graham coming to do a major event. But imagine a place that is just represents the Church of Jesus Christ in the city. Imagine a place where people rise up in faith and they're able to make spiritual decrees of truth before the Lord and see things like the gathering demoniac coming into his right mind. This is a place where the Lord's presence is there to help people think about their lives, where you can come in, you can be saturated in the presence of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit can minister to the depth of your being. Imagine that place. Imagine a place that has secured the cooperation of the churches in the city, and so that we're all as one together in this project. Imagine a place that's filled with the glory of God. Imagine a place that functions like a portal from heaven. And just like Jacob put his head on the rock and he slept and he had a dream, and that place was a portal from heaven, and there were the angels going back and forth, and there was a ladder from earth to heaven. Imagine a place like that in the city. That's what God wants. And wherever it happens, all across the world, the spiritual atmosphere of the city and the region changes tangibly, so that certain resistances that are encountered as people try to promote the gospel, they're just not there anymore.
Praise God.
There's an ease of access. The gospel is received because there's something going on that speaks well of the church. And no one can say the church is divided, because everybody knows there's a place right there and all the churches are for it and moving ahead. Imagine a place that simply expresses the unity of the Spirit in peace for the whole region. Imagine a place where young and old come and they can be excited together in the presence of God. But in particular, the young people are able to come and catch fire. There is such a place in Kansas City. I know there are many such places around the world, but they never come cheaply. They always come with a cost. I'm Jim Leuschen, and I'm the pastor of New Covenant Fellowship, and this has nothing to do with New Covenant Fellowship. Because the vision of God, what God wants, is so much bigger than any one person. None of us can contain it. None of us can understand it. And it isn't about my vision or your vision. It's about the vision of God and apprehending together that vision. And we as the people of God, we owe it to ourselves to let our imagination loose and imagine how much God can do as we come together. If it's really true that one chases 1,000 but two chases 10,000, then what happens when the Church of Jesus Christ unites in the city to say, we're going to focus on having the Spirit of God in our midst like never before?